In this lesson, I will show you the power of the authentication module and what you can build on top of it. The authentication option is not activated by default in your account. So you need to go to the add-on store and add it to your project. Once it's done, you will see new menus appearing inside your backend. The first thing to do is to start working with the settings menu to set up the authentication in your account. The first question to answer is sign up. Do you want people to sign up inside your app, or do you prefer them to log in with existing credentials you've already given to them? And do you want people to skip the sign up process to access your content even if they're not logged? The second question is the authentication method. By default, people can log with the email and password they've created on the platform. But if you want, you can also authorize authentication with external services, Facebook and Twitter. Please take the time to set up those external authentication systems, because for your end users, it's very, very fast and easy to connect them inside your app. Let me show you. Pretty fast. Under the user profile tab, you will choose the information people will give upon registration. When you ask an information to be filled, you can decide to make it public, private, or invisible, and you can make it mandatory or not. Public values will be seen by everyone using the app, private values only by the user connected, and invisible, it's for you, the app owner. You can use this field to put personal information you want to store for a contact. Now that people can log inside your app, you can propose them many interesting features. All the add-ons in the user's features library can now be activated. User groups will enable you to fine-tune the access to parts of your app. I have already two groups of users in this app, the co-workers and the design team. I'm going to add a new group. Now, let's add users to the product team group. Let me filter my users by coworkers. And those three, they also belong to the product team. So let's move them to this group. I have four groups in my app now, and you notice that some users can belong to more than one group. Let's move to the public-private page to fine-tune the access to the app. From this page, I see all the sections of my app, and I can restrict the access for the section I like. When I set a section to private, by default, it will be accessible by all groups. But if you want, you can decide which group can access this section. In this example, we see that the New York section can be accessed to the design team, the product team, and the guest team. If I want, I can also restrict the access to the app itself. Just toggle to private the restriction on the root level. Let's see the result using the app now. I'm connected as a guest. So if I go to the places section and I want to access the New York section, it's okay because the guest can access it. But if I want to go to the Corsica section, I'm not authorized because I don't have the right access to go to this section. Let's have a look now at the community add-on. It's the place where you can display the users of your app. Several options are available to create the perfect directory. You can customize the look and feel of the user list. You have two templates you can play with. And you can also customize the public profile of the user. Looking at the settings of this section, you will discover very powerful options. The search engine, and you can activate or not some criteria to refine the search. The search criteria depends on what you ask during the sign-up process. So here I have two drop-down menus where I ask some values, food preference and also preferred color, and those values will be used as search criteria in the search engine. You can also give the possibility to filter the list of users. So to create a filter, select one or several groups you have already created on your user list and give a name to the filter. Let's have a look at the result in app. I have here all my users. I can filter by group. Let's display only the member of the design team. Switch back to all users and make a search. So I have already performed some searches that are stored. So let's go and look at the Ajaccio search and refine the results by food preference. Here I have the filter results for the search on the keyword Ajaccio. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. See you next time, and meanwhile, happy app building. Test all my table.